We are sitting at River Creek Wildlife Management Area. We are in one of our woodpecker recruitment clusters, which is a site we chose, and we came in and installed some inserts so that the birds would have ready-made housing, so to speak, because it takes them so long to make a cavity on their own. One reason we picked this spot is this was one of the last historic clusters where woodpeckers occurred on the property in the past. So it seemed like a logical place to put a cluster, and it's turned out pretty well. Each individual bird has his or her own cavity that they use, one bird per cavity, and they will usually use that cavity each night. The eggs are typically laid in the breeding male's cavity, but you know, both birds will incubate the eggs. They do have alternate cavities. Sometimes a cavity may be taken over by a flying squirrel or some other bird that likes to use cavities, in which case sometimes they'll move to another tree. But usually they'll remain in the same cavity. Sometimes the same bird will use the same cavity for many, many years. Well, red-cockaded woodpeckers have an interesting biology and life history. They are cooperative breeders. So a male and a female, the breeding male and female will live in this cluster site and use these cavity trees. But also they may have what are called helpers, which live in the cluster with them, but don't breed. The clusters are typically their offspring from past years who have given up the opportunity to go and become breeders themselves to stay in the cluster site. And what they'll do is they will help excavate cavities, which is a laborious process. They will also feed young and just sort of help with the dynamics of the cluster. And clusters with helpers may be more successful long term. And at some point, these helpers may disperse and become breeders on their own. That often happens. And what may also happen is if there's a male helper here and the breeding male dies, one of the helper males may assume that breeding role in the cluster.